once again, I welcome you all to RKP online classes, and of course, this is your English teacher Venu Sehrawat, and we are going to continue with the same lesson, that is lesson 8, the purloined letter. All right, and so far we have read that Monsieur G, who is the prefect of Parisian police, and he is handling, he has been handling a case in which, you know, a letter has been stolen by a person, and he also knows the person, that who is the person. So it was Minister D, but of course they are not able to, you know, get a hold of him because they don't have a proof, and they are not able to find the letter even after searching his apartment and searching on his body as well. So they did not get anything out of that. So at last he has come to his friend whose name is Auguste Dupin, right? And who is a detective. So earlier also many times he has taken his help whenever he found himself in a fix, in a problem. All right, so now he comes here and he seeks for his advice, right, on how to proceed in this particular case. All right, so let's proceed further and open your book at page number 96 now. I hope you all have the notebook and the pencil with you. Great. All right, Dupin advises Monsieur G on his investigation. Now after being asked, Dupin has an advice, a piece of advice for the prefect, right? Let's know more about that. And so he says, my friend, search his apartment again. That is the only advice I can give you. And once again, Dupin came up with this idea of going again in his apartment and searching it thoroughly, right? Okay, a month or so later, seated again in the back library, we receive Monsieur G, who has come to see us. He has still not found the letter. He promises to write a check of 50,000 francs to anyone who would bring him the letter. All right, so after taking his advice, Monsieur G, he went out, right? And then again, they meet, the three people, they meet at the same place, all right? At the library, they are in the library now. And the situation is the same. It hasn't changed even a bit because even after ample efforts, he is Monsieur G, he is not able to find the letter, right? And now he is so frustrated out of the about this problem, because of this problem, that he says, whosoever would find me the letter, I would give him a check of how many francs? 50,000 francs. Imagine, such a big amount, right? And with a francs is a currency, right, which was earlier used in France and Paris, right? Which was earlier used in France and Paris, it was francs. But now it is I mean, it's no longer in use, and now they have the currency euro. All right, so he said that, you know, I would give 50,000 francs to the person whosoever helps me out in this problem. I have failed to find the letter, and I will at this time gladly write a check of 50,000 to whoever can find me the precious letter. Now he is so you know, upset about the problem, and he says, I'm not able to find the letter, and now I will be very happy to write a check of 50,000 francs to that person, okay, whosoever finds me the letter, the precious letter, right? Precious means something very valuable, all right? So then here comes the twist. Now, what is the twist here? See, Dupin says, then you better write that check to me. Can you believe this? I mean, and quickly too. Now, Dupin says, you better write that check to me. Oh my God. Now, what do you think? Is it Dupin who has done it? Who has stolen the letter? Who has purloined the letter? Do you really think so? Let's find out. Alright, now coming to page number 97. Monsieur G wrote Dupin a check of 50,000 francs. Dupin astonishes everybody. See, he is a detective, right? He's a detective. So everybody, including me, and I hope you too, everybody will think it this way that, you know, he'll help him out now, right? He'll help and he himself will investigate the case now, right? And this is how he will help. But now, the moment of truth is that Dupin himself has the letter with him. Okay, now, and the moment he hands over the check to Dupin comes up with the letter, and he says, he says, here you are. And the moment he does so, Dupin says, thank you, and here's your letter. Wow, it's so surprising. And of course, Monsieur G was surprised, but of course he knows that, you know, Dupin is detective, right? And he is accustomed to doing such things, right? Surprising everybody. So Monsieur G rushes out with the letter. Rush out is a phrasal verb to go out hurriedly, okay? Hurriedly. So he got his letter, so he rushes out immediately with the letter. The nature of the search that the Parisian police carries out is such, and this is known to everybody, including the minister, that is merely thorough and rigorous. Now they are talking, Auguste Dupin and the narrator. And then Dupin says, see, everybody is aware. Everybody knows how the police in Paris, they work. And how do they work? I mean, they just do it, and it is very easy to you know, think like the policeman, right? Because they just do the investigation on the upper ground, okay? They don't go in depth, they don't go in the details. So, and the Auguste Dupin says that this is the reason. I mean, Minister D is quite aware about this thing. He is aware of the police working, how they actually work. So it was very easy to for the minister to, you know, to betray and to befool the police, right? It was very easy for him to trick them, right? So merely, the word merely here means beta only, merely only. Merely means only. Alright, it is quite methodical. Methodical is means there is a process, right? and there are some steps of doing it. Always the same thing, right? So suppose if there is a thief, right, and he knows that, you know, this is how the system works. First they will come at my apartment, they will see the things, right? They will check the things, they will search behind the paintings and all these things. So if he is aware of this thing, and methodology is always the same, it never changes, so it's very easy for someone, right, to imagine, right, and to assume that how the things will go, right? So that is the reason it was very easy for the minister to to betray the police. Then and it's nothing more, it pays little attention to the brilliance of the criminal mind, right? And Dupin here says that, you know, it is a failure of a Parisian police because they fail to think like a criminal does, right? They do not think, if they want to catch a thief, they should actually go into their shoes and they should, you know, think like them. Only then they will be able to catch him and solve the mystery, right? And according to Dupin, the police at Paris, they fail at doing it, right? So it does not try to find out how a criminal's mind work, right? So the same thing, they don't think like a criminal. They search the minister's apartment over and over again, but they search the same places, right? So he is saying they went there, they went into the apartment, but every time their method is same. So how it's going to change the situation? It will remain the same, isn't it? So now from this, the narrator says, from this I can understand the letter was procured from the criminal's apartment, but how did you procure it? Now, procured means found out, okay? From found out. Now, of course, Dupin, he has found out the letter from the criminal's apartment, right? But now the narrator is curious. He is quite eager to know that, you know, how Dupin actually, he had done it, right? So, we'll continue with the same thing in the next video. Narrator was in a great surprise and he asked him, how did you procure it? Okay, now the word procure, it means to find something or to get something, to obtain something actually, not actually find, but to obtain something, okay? To obtain something. Alright, so he asked him this thing. Now, turn the page. We are at page number 98 now. Well, now Dupin, he started describing him the whole situation. Now, when I visited him, the more I considered the intelligence of the minister, the more I believed that the best way he could think of concealing the letter while keeping it handy so he could destroy it at a moment's notice, and was to not conceal it at all. Now here comes the trick that Dupin used here, okay? He actually thought as a criminal, right? And he said, I just thought like a criminal, and I thought that a criminal, he would think that, you know, instead of hiding it somewhere underneath all right? Instead of that, I should keep it handy. Handy means which is approachable, near you, within your reach. Okay, handy means within your reach. Handy, within your reach. Within your reach or easily accessible, right? Okay, so he said instead of hiding it somewhere, a criminal will keep it handy so that if somebody gets to know about it, he will have the opportunity to destroy it, to damage it, to ruin it, to finish it off, to get rid of it, right? At that particular moment, okay, without wasting any time. So I thought like that criminal only, and I thought the criminal would not hide it somewhere, right? And instead of that, he will keep it somewhere near him and which will be easily accessible, right? So with this idea, I went to the minister's apartment myself and performed my own search. And keeping this thing in my mind, I went to the minister's apartment. I went to his place and I conducted my own search. I searched the whole apartment according to me, according to my mind, whatever my mindset, right? So we'll continue with the same lesson in the next video. Thank you so much.